Well, space is there, and the moon and the planets are there, and new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Stretch of the tour. Will, would you like to say anything?
This water better be warm.
Let's go! Did it.
That's the ocean out there. Climbed like 200 feet.
Heading to Antenitas.
Continue to go up.
Pannier just snapped off, broke at the freaking bottom, and look at the hooks, man. They got muffed up. How's that even happen?
Sorry, Mr. Sabo.
Coast, and life is pretty good right now. Chilling right on the water all day today. Originally, we're gonna chill here for a little bit, and then head up to LA, then out to Coachella. But things worked out. We're gonna stay a lot longer, and then head out to Coachella straight from here. And then chill and camp with some people at Joshua Tree, and it's gonna be killer. Joshua Tree for free, National Park Week, go to your national park. By the time you guys see this video though, it'll be over with.
Back from my adventure. So we made it to California, and for the last like 18 days, we were talking about how badly we wanted to sit on the beach and drink. Pretty excited. Probably doing this again tomorrow too.
Your mind out, move the body back to my bed. But I know what you mean. You want to buy some fire, you want to watch.
Alright, so after a 3-day hiatus from the bikes, we're getting back on the bikes and heading up to Temecula. We're gonna ride the coast a little. Oh no, the lens. I gotta clean the lens. We're gonna ride the coast a little bit, head out to Temecula, stay a night with Brooke yet again, and we're going to then head straight to Coachella, where we're gonna work with Spicy Pie, make pizzas for 3 days straight, and completely lose our minds.
Yeah.
Again, after completing a trip like this.
So we showed up to San Diego on Monday morning and really had no plan of where to stay. It was kind of just like, you know, ad-libbing like usual. And we got this hookup with Sharon. She's got this dope place in, what town is this?
We're in Encinitas.
Encinitas, right by Solana Beach. And she hooked us up with some awesome food and some trips to the beach. We got to see Cabrillo National Monument, got to see Pacific Beach, and eat some really good Mexican food. We went to the original Rubio's, and we went to, what was that, Coyote Lounge last night? Yeah.
Coyote Cafe.
I think
it was Cafe Coyote.
And of course, she knows the owner, so yeah. It was a good time. And I'm not too excited about heading east on a bicycle. It's kind of like back the way we came. But it's gonna be fun going to Coachella to see all these fucking crazy people.
Not really looking forward to getting back on this shit. But bikes are still holding up. Oh, we should probably figure out flights home too, because we're really cutting down. Plus, we're cutting down on money. So we're carrying two PB&Js each. We're hoping that lasts us today. And water. So we'll see. What else? We hit Ballast Point. That was sick.
Yes.
We got a hook up there. Got free beer. Practically.
Literally, yeah. Didn't charge us.
Didn't charge us at all.
I think there was a miscommunication there.
But we picked up a six pack from them, so.
Pineapple Sculpin, not as good as grapefruit Sculpin, so.
Still banging. Needs more pineapple. I think everything's charged. GoPro's charged. We're gonna get as much footage as we can on the coast, because that'll just be sick.
We're hoping for no giant hills either, because that just sucks.
Crossing our fingers for that. Okay, we went swimming in that pool, the jacuzzi, earlier today when we got here, and that was awesome. Time to relax, and we got some time to, we We hit up the wineries. We got fish tacos at Rubio's. We hit up the originals yesterday, and Rubio's here in Temecula, which is where we're at right now, obviously. We're trying to get the Joshua Tree, which is over 100 miles from here. Coachella's like 70-some. But I have a flat. Managed to get a flat again. It's a chore. You know, we're thinking about the next day constantly, and it's annoying. You just want to get to camp and kind of just rest instead of worrying about stuff. So
my bag on the left side, or no, the right side of my bike popped off about 3 or 4 times in the last couple of days. And the last
three or four times today.
probably closer to half a dozen. But today the zipper actually broke, so I couldn't get my shit out of my bag. So now I had to rip the zipper off, and I can't close it now. So this thing is literally going to just be an entire thing of duct tape, because I now have to close my bag with duct tape. So for the fourth time, I'm sorry, Sabo. I really did a number on your bags. So thanks, though.
First patch, second patch, third patch, 4 or 5, counted as 1. Duct tape does count, right? We're gonna inflate the tube now, and a little trick we've been doing: inflate your tube, put in some water, and you'll see bubbles. That's where your hole is. Dry it off, put a patch on, good to go. You might be able to hear it.
Yeah.
Not without getting wet.
Yo, straight through the duct tape. Solid patch work, Matt. Solid patch work.
Watch this. All right, ready?
First try.
Ah. Second try. All
right, maybe third try.
All right, time to put it back in the tire.
So Vail Lake, California, not Colorado, it's fucking California. And another flat tire if you didn't hear last time. We're up to like a lot now. This road sucks, but the scenery is beautiful. Too loud to film. More climbing. Always. That's the beach way over those mountains.
Will and I began our bike ride this morning from Temecula, and our goal was to get to Joshua Tree, which was pretty far. Mainly we wanted to get to Coachella and then possibly hitch a ride up to Joshua Tree. Anza. Just past the town of Anza, California, and I'm by myself. My bike's dead. My bike is probably more exhausted than I am. But yeah, maybe there's a bike shop ahead where Will could pick up some tubes, or a tube at least, so we could bike from Joshua Tree to Coachella. Because again, we're supposed to be meeting employees there, coworkers, at Joshua Tree before we work the second weekend at Coachella. Which, from looking at Coachella's Instagram page, is reckless right now. So hopefully the second weekend is just as fun. Which probably will be. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna sit here, try to make some calls, drink some beer. This is the end of my trip right here. This is it. unless I bike out a Joshua tree. So I'm all good. I got food, got water. It's literally just a waiting game now. If I have to, I'll camp here.
So if you can hear the wind, I'm now heading eastbound, solo, and just getting fucked by headwinds. Come on. Matt's bike is so messed up, he had to stop riding. I feel bad for him. But I'm gonna keep going. So, I've been climbing for the last half an hour. Right before I started the climb, it said elevation 4,000 feet. I don't know how tall this hill is. Fuck hills, this is a fucking mountain.
Beautiful, though.
So, just found out that bikes aren't allowed on this road. Or in the Native American reservation, so. Whee! Looks like I'm doing it anyway. So I got a 25-ounce beer in my bag. I'm wondering if anyone's ever tried to shotgun a 25-ounce beer and then bike like 30 miles. I don't think I'm gonna try it. I'm just gonna start riding, so.
Got them apples.
Dude, fucking crushing these uphills. Trying to get that Coachella bod, dude. I did like 23 push-ups today, so that should suffice. This douchebag and his Escalade, fuck you. So much money out here, man. I've seen like 4 Maseratis today. Literally not exaggerating, probably 30 to 40 Corvettes. Lotus Elise, I've seen 3 of those.
So we left Brooke's place in Temecula on Saturday morning. We rode to the town of Anza. By the time we got there, we had already had five flats, all mats. And at about 3 o'clock, we decided that I was gonna keep going and just make it as far as I could. And this dude was gonna stay in the town and wait for Brooke and Carrot and Salsa to pick him up, because we didn't know how much room was gonna be in the Jeep. So I made it to almost Indio, in between Palm Springs and Indio,
They picked me up about 6:30. We came out to Joshua Tree with no plans, like literally nothing. We just kind of showed up Saturday night. Everything's full, you know, every single campground, there's not a single spot. So we showed up to, there's a Cottonwood campground, and the group sites here are massive. And apparently you can rent all of them out for one party. This guy said it was cool if we use one of the spots, and we're like, okay, that's cool, cool, whatever. So we go and visit a little bit later in the night. Turns out that it's like 12, 14 gay dudes all on a big camping adventure in Joshua Tree.
Ate breakfast. Next morning.
Hung out with them for a few hours, and then just had a sweet day of adventuring through Joshua Tree. Checked out Jumbo Rock, Skull Rock. Then we took a little visit to Del Taco.
Del Taco.
Basically chilled there for like an hour and a half.
That was awesome. We needed the AC. The heat, I think, got to everybody pretty quickly.
We definitely hit a point about 45 minutes into our little hike where everyone just was like, I'm so nauseous and tired and dehydrated. And we were all freaking out that we weren't going to get enough like nourishment to make it back to the camp. Even with a car. Did some off-road in the Jeep. Shout out Kara.
Yeah, shout out Kara.
That killed it today. And insane. Now we're here in the middle of nowhere by ourselves.
Yeah, so they just left us. We are now stranded in the desert. Yeah.
So basically,
this is one of the few places with water too.
It's like the only campground in the park with water, and we don't have any service.
I was just gonna say, probably the number one thing: no service. This is the only location for water. There's a lot of things that we could do. One's to go to Jumbo Rock, and that's just over 30 miles away, and that would be a trip, and that would be to meet employees from Spicy Pie for Coachella. Yeah, and where we're going, there's just no water,
and we have no way of communicating with these people, and I don't have any of their numbers, so basically we're told to look for a red pickup truck, a Subaru Forester, and some other big truck that's towing an RV of some sort. And this park is like literally ginormous. It took us like an hour to drive through the whole park today.
So, and we're still struggling with the tire issues. Luckily, Kara hooked us up
with Dixon Flat.
Did it. We survived Coachella. We didn't see too many shows. Heard all of them for the most part. We did 4 days of work. Thursday only being 2 hours, but total we got about 45 hours in. Pretty tired. It's Monday right now. And our goal was to pretty much just get a ride right to LA, and it still is, but we woke up this morning, we didn't get done working really this morning until 3:30. We woke up this morning and found out both of our rides bailed on us. Yeah, we ended up getting another ride. I think it's only like 11 o'clock right now, so we have all day. We're just waiting for her to break down the camp. So yeah, legs are tired, we're exhausted. Coachella's pretty much mayhem. 2 hours to LA. And we fly home in a couple days.